So references can be imported into EndNote directly from a database, but it's important to first have an understanding of what a citation record looks like. Not all resources that you might want to use will have an option to, or will have an electronic record or an option to directly export to EndNote. So this might be if you're looking at a government document or a website. So you can still add these resources to your EndNote library, but you'll just need to add them manually. So this is where we'll use the New Reference button. And this will open a new reference window, and this is where we're going to add the relevant information. The first thing we'll need to do when we're adding a new reference is select the appropriate reference type. So by default, it's selected journal article. However, if I expand this, we can see there's a great big long list of reference types here. So different fields are shown and are used or are active for the different reference types from this list. So this is again where it's useful to have an understanding of referencing and your referencing style to know, to be able to identify what resource type you're using and what elements or what information needs to be displayed in what format to appropriately reference that resource. I'm going to start today by selecting a book. So even just selecting that, some of these fields have updated because books require different information than journal articles. Now there's lots of fields in this record. I don't need to add information to each of them. I just need to add in the details that are required for the reference or that might be useful for me in terms of keeping track of this book in case there's something I want to look up about it later. Okay, so I'm going to enter some details in now. Okay, so with my details entered, a couple of things to note. So as I mentioned, I haven't filled in every field. I have put in my author's year, title, place of publication and publisher, and also the edition. With authors, we need to enter each author on a new line. So after, directly after the N in association, I hit the enter key, and then I added my second author name. With author names, we're also aiming for consistency in how we enter them. So for my second author, I've got surname, comma, first name, and I've written that first name in full. So if in the future I have more references that I'm adding by this same author, I want to try and make sure I've written it out in this same format. These author names are also in red, which is indicating that these are new authors to EndNote, because it again is trying to match author names to see, is this the same author or is this a different author? So that's again where your consistency comes in. Okay, with all those details entered, I'm just going to select the Save button and then close the reference window. And we can see this reference has been added to my references pane. I can see my all references count has gone up to 1. On the Summary tab, we're getting just that, a summary of the reference, which lists the title, author, publication, details, and where available, it will give the DOI and the abstract. At the bottom of the Summary tab, we have our referencing style, options to insert or copy the citation. It's also expanded up and is showing me a preview of the citation. This preview is showing me how it will display the record or the reference formatted by the selected referencing style. From this preview, we can see there's an issue with this reference. So particularly looking at how EndNote is treating my first author, the Australian Food Association. So that's a corporate author, meaning, you know, it's not a person with a first name and middle name and surname and so on. So I need to tell EndNote that this is a corporate author and make it display that name in full. We can fix this by going to the Edit tab. To get the corporate author to display in full and not treat it as if it's a person whose surname is Association and Australian Food are their first or their personal names, all I need to do is add a comma to the end of the name. We can see that text has gone red because it is recognising Australian Food Association as a corporate name as a new author within my library. So now I'll select Save. And now if I go back to the summary, we can see it's updated those author that author detail.